Whenever we see a plant, we see its green color. And for that reason, somewhat, we always associate the color green with plants. This green color in plants is all because of the cells it possesses in its outer surface, which is green to be precise. It carries a pigment in it, which is actually green. Pigments are chemical substances which has a property to absorb all the wavelength of visible spectrum except a few. It is those few wavelength of light coming out of it as a reflection emits its color. Or in reality, that is what we perceive with our vision. Now plants possess something called chlorophyll, which has a property of absorbing all but the green color. Thus plant appear to be green. But its function is not limited to that of giving color. It is responsible for one of the most important biochemical reactions called photosynthesis. It is a process in which atmospheric CO2 and water from soil gets assimilated by the plant to make carbohydrate, which is the food for all living organisms. For all this to happen, plant needs to harness the sunlight, and it is chlorophyll that helps in it. The photopigment chlorophyll can be found present in a dedicated organelle in eukaryotic plant cells called the chloroplast. It is one type of plastids. It is a double membrane bound organelle with an independent system of its own, means it can control all its necessary functions. And for that, a control center is required, which is a single circular DNA that can be found in its matrix. The matrix of the chloroplast behaves like cytoplasm and helps in every single biochemical reactions that occur here. The chloroplastid matrix also goes by the name of stroma. Other structures that can be found will be polyribosome, which is multiple ribosomes bound to a single messenger RNA. And this is the one that produces all the necessary proteins. The most prominent and important structure that can be found here will be the membrane-bound sacs called thylakoid, which gets stacked up forming granum. The adjacent granas can be found to have membranous bridge between them called the stroma lamellae. Point to be noted here that it is the grana, or exactly the thylakoid, where photosynthesis begins with the harnessing of light energy, but it is completed with the production of carbohydrate in the stroma, which houses the enzymes needed for completing the process. It also possesses some amount of stored starch granules. Another type of plastids that can be found in plant will be leucoplast, which lacks any pigment and is actually a storage organelle. Depending on the type of molecule substances it stores in it, it can be called amyloplast, which stores starch, alluroplast that stores proteins, and elaioplast, which stores lipid. Chromoplast is actually a pigment bearing for plastid that gives specific color to the parts of the plant, as it contains different color pigments in it, other than the chlorophyll. As the food being produced in chloroplast, it needs to be converted into energy, because it is the energy that is necessary to run the biological processes. For this reason, there is a specific organelle in eukaryotic cells called mitochondria. Its sole purpose is to produce energy in the form of a specific molecule called adenosine triphosphate, or ATP in short. It is called an energy currency as it behaves like one unit of energy in a cell. Now for that reason, it can be found in both animal and plant cells. And thus, mitochondria is an organelle that can be found in both animal and plant cells. Mitochondria, just like chloroplast, consist of two membranes. But in this case, the inner mitochondrial membrane is folded inwards. This folding produces several finger-like projections called cristae. On this crystal can be found unnecessary proteins to carry out oxidative phosphorylation that produces adenosine triphosphate. This process is carried out by a special structure called oxysome or ATP synthetase. It phosphorylates adenosine diphosphate and produces adenosine triphosphate. The detail of this will be covered in the chapter of respiration. The mitochondrial matrix consists of all necessary components to carry out the processes like Krebs cycle, which helps in the production of ATP. Mitochondrial DNA is a small circular DNA just like the chloroplast, which contains all the genes necessary for running its biochemical processes. And it also has polyribosomes by which the proteins are produced. Both mitochondria and chloroplast can duplicate itself by a process that resembles binary fission, and this process is autonomous. Symbiosis is a close relationship between organisms of different species that live together. Now, there is a theory called the theory of endosymbiosis that proposes that some of the today's eukaryotic organelles has evolved by a symbiosis in which one species of prokaryote was engulfed by another species of prokaryote, where the engulfed prokaryote started providing the host with certain advantages associated with their special metabolic activities. This resulted in the symbiotic relationship in which both of them are benefited, and the engulfed prokaryote somehow became the organelle. For the biggest example will be chloroplast and mitochondria, where evidences suggest that the two membranes are actually the membrane of the phagosome, which became the outer membrane, and the membrane of the prokaryote itself became the inner membrane. Now, all the necessary components can be found in the inner membrane of the organelle, which is just like that we see in case of the prokaryote, where all its necessary functions, it majorly resides in the inner membrane. Polyribosomes, the circular DNA, they are also characteristics of that of the prokaryotic cell. And most importantly, the ribosome also resembles somewhat like that of the prokaryotic cell. The two organelles also replicate itself just like the way a bacteria do. Plus, their semi-autonomic nature also inclined towards that theory.